to EQ International, India's largest solar media. Joining us today is Mr. Hardeep Singh, CEO of Solar Business from Jackson Group, and Mr. Gagan Channa, CEO of Distributed Energy Business, Jackson Group. Welcome, sir. Welcome.
Thank you.
Before we start the interview, can we have some information about the company? Please tell us.
Jackson is a 70-year-old company. We started off with our genset business, which is our we are OEM with Cummins, and we ventured into the solar business about 10 years back. So currently we are 360 degrees into the solar space. So we are into IPP, we have EPC, and we are into solar manufacturing. So in manufacturing, we have into solar module manufacturing as well as module mounting structures. And now we are also getting into the distributed energy space, which is your energy storage systems and even hydrogen.
Okay. So with regards to the COP commitments, COP26 commitment, what do you think is the scope of Indian market now?
So I think there is a commitment from Government of India in the COP26, and with regard to net zero, we have to become carbon net zero by 2070. It's a long commitment, I think, which has been given by our PM, but I think we need to move towards it very quickly. We are moving towards it just because of the focus on renewables, which has started happening. By 2030, Government of India has committed 450 gigawatt of energy through renewables. Mostly it will happen through solar. And also there's a hydrogen mission, national hydrogen mission, which has been established this year. A lot of focus is going to be there on hydrogen generation, green, particularly green hydrogen generation, as well as usage for power production.
With respect to that, what is your production capacity?
So, as Aditi mentioned, we are focusing on renewables quite a lot. We are already into DG industry, which is a fossil fuel based industry. So, we also committed to become net zero by venturing into other renewable energy sources like solar and hydrogen. So I think we'll be able to do it much quicker than Government of India.
That's great. That's a very promising commitment to make. What are your expansion plans, if Mr. Hardeep could answer that?
Yeah, sure. So on the solar side, as we have a 500 megawatt line coming up within this month, end of this month. And then our ultimate plan is to go for 2+2 by 2022. Which is 2 gigawatts of modules and cells. And on the module mounting structure side also we are expanding to 20,000 metric tons a year.
What is the technical roadmap? Are there any new product launches recently? Could you talk about them?
See, we have always, as far as solar is concerned, we've always been ahead of the curve. In 2019, we were the first Indian manufacturer to launch the 400 watt peak module. And this year, we were the first Indian manufacturer to launch the 600 watt peak module. And also the first Indian manufacturer to launch a module which was designed in India, made in India completely, and with an efficiency of 21% and above. So that's the work which is constantly being done at our back end by our R&D team. And we plan to continue that and try and be ahead of the curve on this.
What percent of your profit goes into R&D, if that is something that you would be okay with explaining?
Well, there's no defined percentage as such, but it is more need based. So at times when the requirement, the focus is on some particular project, so the investment goes up. So it's very much need based as such. There's no defined percentage.
Recently, we have seen that there is an increasing need of hydrogen-based electricity, and I believe that Jackson is involved into hydrogen technology as well. So, could Mr. Gagan talk about it a little?
So, we have a new division which has been formed for new energies. So, that particular division is being headed by a person who actually will focus only on new energies, hydrogen being one of them.
Okay.
So, we are actually working on certain projects. They are in the nascent stage. We are working with certain PSUs and trying to pitch in the hydrogen into hydrogen space there. trying to work out a project which we can have jointly with the PSU.
Is there any project that you would like to talk about that you are handling right now?
We bid for some projects, but I think it's not the right stage to share the information unless we are successful at that.
That's very true. I also believe that storage is one of the very important thing as far as solar is concerned, and it is the future of solar now. So what is your contribution with regards to storage, and where do you see the scope of storage going in the future, in India especially?
So recently we have launched on 22nd of September 21, which was a World Energy Storage Day. We have launched the first Indian storage solution, battery energy storage solution, which is basically a lithium ion based battery based solution. The brand is called Enerpack. So this Jackson Enerpack system, which has been launched, it is going to be available from 5 kilowatt onwards. We have already tested the product in the field. We actually had a seed unit 9 months back. We had installed in Delhi, and it has been quite successful. So this gave us a kind of confidence based on which we launched this product now commercially. So this product is going to be available from 5 kilowatt onwards, and there's no limit to the range what we're going to have. It is purely customized product based on the customer need, customer's pain area with regard to energy, how much backup does he require. So whatever, and this is a smart system. We can actually produce energy through grid, DG, any renewable source, and even hydrogen, and store energy in that energy storage solution and use it whenever there's a requirement for the power.
That sounds very promising. Is there any other solution that your company has recently devised? Any new product that you would like to talk about?
Well, not a new product, but it was a little bit of an innovation on the solar side. So we have just launched the mobile solar generator, which is a portable solution. So in case, you know, in remote areas where there is no grid available, where there is no genset, or there is no fuel available for gensets, so there, you know, this portable mobile solar generator, so it can just be carried on the back of a small SUV, and just you go there and the location, you open up the panels and it starts generating power.
What is the utilization of this mobile generator?
Anywhere, it's coming in very handy, useful for security services.
Okay.
For the police when they are going on operations to remote areas, to border areas.
Even for rural banking services.
Banking.
Okay. Where you need power and power is not available constantly, you would need a backup there. And now recently we have launched a hybrid power solution also. Now since we have a lot of products under our banner, we have a DG which is well reputed. Jackson DG is a very popular DG, and today we are number one in India with regard to DG sets. Then we have the solar solutions. We have battery storage systems. We have hydrogen coming in shortly. So I think we are able to now offer hybrid solutions to the customer. And we are working like an energy consultant now to the customer.
Okay.
In order to work on their needs. What does customer need with regard to energy? And we are there to provide the solution.
So now that we have talked about the opportunities in Indian market, let's talk about the concerns. So since you are talking about concerns, you should also mention BCD, which is also a growing concern among the manufacturers. So what are your thoughts on that?
See, well, there is a conflict of interest there. So while the developers are pushing for the implementation of the DG to be pushed back, so from a manufacturer's point of view, yes, we would like it to come, you know, as of yesterday. And we've been really pushing hard for it. So as of now, the government has announced that it would be implemented from 1st April. And we are just hoping and keeping our fingers crossed that it gets implemented on 1st April.
Any final concluding thoughts that you would like to tell our viewers?
I'd like to tell that we at Jackson are, I think we would be one of the first companies in India to offer energy solutions to the customer. So anybody requiring energy backup, and it could be a hybrid solution, or any pain area which customer has with regard to energy, we are there to support, we are there to help.
Okay. Thank you so much, sir. Thank you so much for making time from your busy schedule and having this interview. Thank you.
So much.